On this episode of the Reynolds Team Podcast, I'm sitting down with Realtor Laura Zink to discuss one of everyone's favorite topics, food spots in Vero Beach, Florida. So thank you for coming on the show, Laura.
Oh, very nice to have you have me.
Absolutely. So first, I like to just have everyone kind of introduce themselves to get to know what their background is and how they found themselves on the Treasure Coast.
Oh, yeah. Thanks for asking. So my name's Laura Zink. I actually graduated from Sebastian River High School in 2008, which is forever ago. You know, I actually moved back here from Port St. Lucie to raise my family. I really love how close-knit the community is and how safe it is as well. There's really not any place that I could really say is the same anywhere on the East Coast of Florida. And, you know, our small town means a lot to a lot of people. You know, there's a lot of different factors that factor into how we keep it that way, and I really enjoy that.
Well, that's great to hear. I think it definitely sounds like you and I like Vero Beach for a lot of similar reasons, because we both grew up here for at least a portion of our lives, and it's always kind of felt as if it were still a small town despite how much it's grown in recent years.
Yeah, exactly. That's how I feel too. And that's great because, you know, being in Port St. Lucie, I lived there for a little over 7 years. The kind of growth that grows there, if you're not familiar, it feels like they could build a building in like 3 weeks. That's how fast it's growing there. And, you know, it's nice to like come back here and see the growth in a healthy way instead of it being like a monstrosity just taking over and then see people coming. No, you know, nothing to take away from Port St. Lucie. You know, it's great in its own ways. But for me and my family, this area suits me much better.
Absolutely. And I think one of the biggest things, considering how we both know the area very well, mm-hmm. working as a realtor here, you experience all the different areas and kind of subcultures of the Vero Beach area. I think one of the things that is definitely appealing, except for obviously the beach, the wildlife, and the Indian River County experience, is some of the staple food places that really kind of make up Vero Beach culture. Mm-hmm. And so I just wanted to get into when you first came to Vero, or when you were really kind of starting to come of age to kind of choose where you like to go for food and groceries, were there any peculiar restaurants or food spots that stuck out to you or that you've become a regular of?
Yeah, there's actually a couple of different restaurants. One that's been around since the 90s. It's a little hole-in-the-wall place. It's called Mimo's Italian Grill. It's on 58th and 60. I really enjoy going there. It's authentic, fresh Italian cuisine. The portions are so large. It's almost like getting two meals for the price of one. And I like a good deal, of you know, and to have that kind of flavor that goes along with it. They use fresh ingredients as well, which is huge. It's not a chain restaurant, and being a local, you know, I really like to support local businesses and make sure it stays in the community instead of going to chain restaurants and corporations.
Yeah, I think that's definitely a very big positive, especially beachside of Vero Beach, where the town and the community has really tried to maintain a lot of that local culture. Exactly. Whereas you have all these small business restaurants that have been here for years and decades, and they still have a ton of regular customers. They don't get a lot of outside flack or competition from other, you know, big businesses and restaurants trying to come in. So it really kind of preserves a lot of that original culture that's very appealing to this part of Florida.
Yeah, I totally agree with that as well. And there's also another one that comes to mind. It's a newer restaurant. It's called the Green Marlin. Their slogan is actually, go where the locals go, meet you at the Marlin. And, you know, the owner there, his name is Lou. He's a chef, and he made all of these different dishes from scratch. He made up the recipes. They have fresh daily. They have different specials that go on. They bring in mussels and oysters. Yeah, oysters. And things of that sort. So anyhow, it's just a really great experience. And like, you know, a bonus on that is to go there on Sunday brunch is out of this world. It's kind of set up like a buffet style. And, you know, due to COVID, they have different restrictions and they keep it safer, even as a buffet. And they have endless mimosas. So who doesn't want that on a Sunday brunch? So.
I think I know where I'm going to be this Sunday all of a sudden.
Yeah.
So I think one of the big things that potential clients or buyers who are looking into coming into the area is everyone kind of wants that slice of paradise when they move to the state, especially for retirement. And one of the big things they think about is if I'm going out to the beach or to kayak or really kind of do any of the beachside activities in Vero Beach, they kind of start to think about, well, am I going to enjoy the people? Am I going to enjoy the food? Because the food's very important.
Oh, yeah.
What beachside food spots really kind of stick out to you as far as recommendations?
You know, there's a, if you're looking for like a quick eat and a really good burger, I would suggest heading over to Casey's Place. It is phenomenal. I don't even really know how to describe it. I know I recommend it to all my clients when they're looking for something quick and a little salty and savory all in one. And that is located in Central Beach. And I believe it's right there on Azalea. I think it's the road that it's on. And there's another one that's called Cravings. So if you're looking for like a little healthier flair instead of, you know, the burgers, it has, they use like kind of organic ingredients, and they actually on Saturday, they have, maybe Sunday as well, they have live music. So something that I enjoy as well as some of my close friends, we like to go over to the farmer's market on Saturday morning, which is from 8 a.m. until noon. And then you can just walk right over to Cravings and enjoy the live music, have fresh coffee, get something small or big, depending on what you're looking for in the mood. And it just really helps wrap up a beautiful day here on the ocean. You know, it's just really nice.
Yeah, and it's interesting when you were just talking about kind of the atmosphere of the farmers market in Vero Beach, and when you talk about all the different food places that are kind of on that drive just off of the beach, a lot of it hasn't really changed in the, I guess, at least the, you know, 20-odd years that I've been here and, you know, the extent of time that you've been here as well. A lot of that really hasn't been touched at all, which is, I think, incredibly appealing, and I think is one of the reasons why Vero Beach gets recommended as kind of this hidden gem along the east coast of Florida.
Yeah, and I completely agree. And, you know, it's really, I have a family now. So being able to share these special places that I loved going to as a kid, or, you know, being able to keep that and be able to pass it on to my children and it still more or less be the same feeling, even 20 years later or 50 years later, you know, some of these are like iconic places in Vero Beach. And I think that that is so special, whether you're looking to retire here or bring your family, this Vero Beach is so versatile. And the places that you came to know and love so many years ago will be here when you're ready to come back.
So I really love that point. And it makes me think about, I'm sure that when you're talking to clients about moving here and you're out there on the road showing homes, if you're trying to encapsulate that idea of what Vero Beach is, where do you take them to go to lunch?
You know, a great lunch spot is actually on the mainland. I prefer taking the clients to a place called Chive. It's a kind of a newer restaurant. It's recently, I guess maybe it's about 10 years old or so. Excuse me if I misquoted the age. But what's really great about that is I have clients that come from all over the country, sometimes internationally, and everybody likes different styles of food. When you go into Chive, you actually have the ability to like create your own entree. They make it in front of you. It's all fresh, top-of-the-line ingredients that if, say, usually you get a rice and bean bowl, which is you pick a protein and you put rice and beans in it. Well, you can add peppers and onions, or you don't have to, you know, and they have like an assortment of different options you can add. That's just one of the great examples. They also have different menu items that they have that are recipes that are already put together that are bursting with flavor. All of their sauces, everything is homemade. They cook the meat or the fish, the product right in front of you. And it's just a great experience. And as Floridians, you know, we really take pride in having fresh fish or fresh food, especially for, you know, people that are moving to the area, because I think that helps bring everything together and explain how we are as a community.
Yeah, I absolutely agree with that point. I think Chive is definitely a place I haven't been to enough to really comment on it, but I've had nothing but good feedback from all my friends and family that have gone there as well. I think that's definitely a good place to go to at really any time of the day for a good meal.
It is. And one more little point about it is, so many people are on different diets. People are allergic to gluten, or they're on the keto diet, and that, you know, some are chosen diets, some are for health related reasons. And having a place like that, which is a big reason I bring my clients there, is so that they're able to pick food and not have to be like, oh, I wish I could eat here, but I'm sorry, I can't. You know, I want them to feel comfortable and be able to order what it is that they're able to eat.
Absolutely agree. Now, in kind of going forward into the future of that interaction, where you've taken the clients out to homes, treated them to a good meal, now you come upon, they've bought a home, it's closing day, they're getting the deed and the keys, and they're wanting to go out to celebrate coming to Vero Beach. What's a formal place for a good night out in the town that you recommend?
Oh, hands down, on the ocean side, I would have to pick the Tides. It is a great kind of romantic atmosphere, something to celebrate with that special someone or someones, to really, it's a one of a kind experience, you know. And their food there, they have a peppercorn encrusted filet mignon, which is just outstanding. Any of their fish are fresh. Again, that's like something Floridians take pride in. You know, we catch fish, and it gives the opportunity for the locals to be able to, occasionally certain restaurants will buy the fish from them. You know, there's some licensing involved, but, you know, the Tides really, it's a great atmosphere. If you're looking for something on the mainland, I would suggest Saber, which is a steakhouse. The presentation of those plates is, you almost don't want to eat it, you know, as are most of the restaurants in town. And something I want to point out as well is these restaurants that I'm mentioning are not chain restaurants. You have to come here to enjoy them. So while you're here, please enjoy the restaurants that we have. And they've done a great job. Some of them during the pandemic even have gone out of their way to provide an even higher level of experience for their clients. And that's really special.
Absolutely agree. I think it's definitely very nice that, especially with how much the city has changed, and especially with the pandemic, how a lot of these restaurants have still been able to flourish and have still been able to keep up their brand because there are so many regular customers that love the food, love the staff, love the owners of all these different restaurants. Yeah. Like, for example, my parents, all when we first moved here, and pretty much all throughout the time we've been in Vero Beach, our best, or like our most favorite Italian place to order out from is Giorgio's. And it doesn't matter how far, or like how long my dad is out of town, whenever we go into the restaurant, they always remember him. And I think that's something where, even though the town keeps growing and changing in different ways, it's interactions like that with the restaurants we love that don't.
I would agree, hands down, with that. Once you're here and you become, you know, a regular, or they start seeing you, they're very good at recognizing faces. You know, they may not necessarily remember your name every time, but they know who you are. A great restaurant, and many of the ones I mentioned, they do. They recognize you the second you walk in the door. We were known for having what they call snowbirds in this area. And it's a treat for some of the servers when you come back and to see you and then hear of like everything that's been going on in your life. That is the kind of feel that these restaurants bring to check in, because you are a part of the community. It doesn't matter if you're here a day, a week, a month, or the whole year. You're such an important part that these men and women that work at these places, they want to make sure that you understand that and feel that way.
Absolutely agree. Yeah, I think there's definitely a great foundation that Vero Beach has with a lot of its food culture. Yeah. And because we are in Florida, I feel like we definitely have to talk about the staple grocery place to go all over the state. There are tons of memes about it. There is a ton of conversation. It's a very controversial topic for a lot of people, but Publix. Publix Deli and their bakery offer some superb varieties of foods and different things to get for whether you're out in the town or you're grocery shopping. So I'm curious, as far as when you will go to any kind of Publix all over town, what do you usually have to get? What are the essentials that you go to at the deli or the bakery?
Well, the first thing that comes to mind, as Publix is pretty iconic for all Floridians, and it's associated with Florida no matter where you go. I have family in Maine, for example, and I was up there visiting them. One of my shirts had Publix on the back, and they instantly knew, oh, you must be from Florida. there are Publixes throughout the country, but it's more well-known here. And one thing that you have to get is, no matter which kind of meat you like, you gotta get a boar's head sub. They bake the bread, and they're pretty, they don't like to give out crusty bread, so they check. You know, as the day goes on, there might be a little harder than others, but they will not give you a bread that's like a hockey puck. And the boar's head has so much flavor. They have different specials that go on. If there's a specific meat that you really want, and it's not already cut, they'll cut it for you out of their deli section. A great thing for me, I'm a mom, as I've mentioned, and you know, I have small kids. I work, and my husband works, and like many families in America, I just run short on time, and I'm not always able to make that home-cooked meal. Being able to stop by a Publix deli and pick up fried chicken, which is amazing at Publix, or their popcorn chicken, and they have an assortment of different sides. You know, it's really nice to have that in relief in the back of my head. Like, okay, you may not have the time it takes to cook all this at home, but at least your family's still getting a well-balanced meal. And it's really nice to have that luxury, I guess. And I mean, who doesn't like fried chicken?
Exactly. Makes me hungry just talking about it.
It is. It's so good.
By far, my favorite thing to get in the Publix deli has got to be the chicken tender sub, which is also another big staple for the Publix delis pretty much all across the state.
Yeah.
That's a pretty signature item that, like, all my friends talk about it. They all have different variations of it. And it's just kind of one of those food items of Florida and really anywhere you go in the state that people just always can have a full-length conversation about.
Absolutely. And like you mentioned, it's so versatile, right? Like, you could have it any different way. You could have it spicy. You could have it with sauce, no sauce, you know, vegetables, no vegetables, like lettuce and things of that sort. But that's another thing that's so great, is to have the versatility of choosing. And of course, I recommend it to my clients as well.
Now, before we wrap things up, I think it's very suiting for the final topic to be on dessert. Oh. So whether you're grocery shopping or you're going out to eat, what's the dessert that you always have got to have at the end of a meal?
Oh, that's a tough one, right? you know, we have what I, so I enjoy going to certain places that the whole family can go to. And Rita's is like, they're amazing. You can have ice cream, you can have gelati, you can have Italian ice, I think is what it's called. But there's so many different choices. So as a family, I would love to go to Rita's. Again, it's locally owned and brings in, you know, everything that we've kind of been discussing this whole podcast. I love going there. Some different restaurants, depending on where I am, I enjoy different desserts. I like turtle cheesecake myself. And so
good choice.
I like to test out restaurants, different desserts, and you know, it's really nice, light deliciousness that you can't, you know, even if it's a little heavy, I mean, it's dessert, it's okay.
Exactly.
Once in a while, yeah.
Yeah, I think there are a ton of great restaurants that have a lot of fantastic desserts. The one that my family and I always resort back to, though, is the Publix carrot cakes.
Oh, those are good.
Absolutely divine. Everyone has to try them at some point, by far. Well, that is all the questions I have about food.
Yeah.
You know, it's definitely very interesting to see how much time you can fill just talking about food, but it is a very great thing to bring up, especially when you're looking at where you want to go next, where you'd love to move to. Food is definitely important.
It is. And, you know, I think it's like an old wives' tale. The quickest way to your husband's heart is through his food, right? Through his stomach. But I joke about that. But being in a community that understands how important it is, I think that really is why it was so easy to discuss food. Besides, now I'm hungry, but.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for coming on the show, Laura.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. I'm glad to be able to be a part of it.
Absolutely, and it's a pleasure to have you. And then stay tuned for more episodes of the Reynolds Team Podcast.
Bye, everyone.